On rare occasions, you'll find that the head during a annual service has become stiff for whatever reason. In this case, it's old hardened grease because this reel's never been serviced. As you can see, it's not turning freely. It is very stiff. So what I'll need to do on this one is, you can find a socket wrench that fits, or you can find these for sale online pretty much all the time. You remove the hex nut right there with this wrench, being careful not to scratch the baffle plate. You put it all the way down onto the hex screw, and then you raise it up just a hair so you don't scratch up the baffle plate. You loosen it up. Once it's loose, then use your fingers. Finish taking it off. Then what you do, or what I do, you see if it's going to come off easy first, which this one is. So I'm going to put a screwdriver in there and we'll take it off. And what that does basically is it leaves everything that's under the baffle plate in place. You can keep it in the right order. And making sure that the shims come off with it, which this one did. There's no shims left under there. So that helps me keep these in the right order. And on this one, the only thing that you'll see is one shim and then the baffle plate washer. So then what you need to do is go ahead and take off the slide here, the guide. Again, making sure you use the right screwdriver. Those are made out of steel, but you can still mess them up. There it comes. Okay, then you lift up the slide, the guide, excuse me. You need to be careful underneath here because some of these will have little shims. This one does not have a shim under there, but you can see the old hardened grease. Okay, after you remove the guide, there's one last thing you need to be careful about. There's going to be another shim right inside there. At least one, sometimes more than one. In this case, there's only one shim. Now you got to make sure that this shim goes back between the head and the housing, because they're different. So make sure you keep these in order. Put them back just like you took them out. I'll be back after the cleaning. Okay, after the parts are clean, you want to check, make sure that when you put the head on, that it now turns freely, which it does. Remembering which shim goes where, this shim goes back first. Put it down there. Then you apply some grease on the stem, and you apply a little bit of grease on the inside here. Then you put it back together. Then again, remembering that the little shim goes on first. It actually fits over top of a little lip there, which you'll see when you do this in person. Then the washer goes on top. Then the baffle plate, you get a little nipple there which fits in the groove. You try to get it on there without hurting anything. Just like that. Then you put the nut back on. Your finger tighten it. Before you go any further, make sure it's still going smooth. Then you go ahead and the same thing, you tighten it down, but don't scratch up the baffle plate. Go down, up just a hair, and tighten it. And just snug is good enough. Then we want to put back in the oscillating guide. Take them both down to snug, and that's it. Didn't do any service on the bell wire because it really didn't need it. Works fine. It spins properly. So that's how you service a head when it needs it.